Hey guys, I'm Gwendolyn with iFixit, and I'm here with Alex, our in-house expert for Apple Watches, who didn't get to go to Japan.
I know, it's a bummer for me, but I mean, it's exciting that I get to do my own teardown here, so I'm very excited to be up here doing
awesome,
a video.
Awesome, great. I can't wait to see what's inside. First off, can you tell us what you brought us today? What is this?
So this is my station for removing the displays from the Apple Watch. I've done about 100, 120 Apple Watches for the Series 1, and I'm trying to preserve the LCD. So this is a reflow station that's usually used for laptop motherboards and logic boards. And I'm using it as a heat-controlled heat gun so that I can melt the adhesive without damaging the LCD.
Smart, smart. So what kind of things do you think we're gonna see inside?
So I already cheated and I looked at our teardown from our Japan team, so I get to know what's inside. So I already know that the connectors are a little bit different for the display. And they're going to be on the bottom here, so I'm going to be coming at it in here. I'm also going to be looking at the antenna because there's a couple different versions in the Series 1. I'm excited to see which one they have in the Series 2 and if it's consistent. And I'm also looking for the display port to see if that's still there. I think I caught a glimpse of it under the lower band, but I want to see it from the inside.
Great. All right, let's get started.
All right, so let's remove these bands. We are.
Oh my gosh, wow. That is the fastest I've ever seen one of these taken apart.
I mean, this setup does its job and that's all we need it for. So let's get it off the table.
Okay. Great, so now we can dig in.
Yeah, so let's start by taking this display off.
Okay.
So let's open this up. And there are the zip connectors. So I haven't seen these before, so let's try to get at them.
So we got the smaller one. This is the 38 millimeter with a resolution of 272 by 340, and it has a pixel density of 290 pixels per inch.
So now that we have the display off, I'm going to try to take the battery out to remove power from the system. So I know that there's a lot of adhesive under here, so I'm going to dig into it and try to get it out as best I can. Perfect. So now let's get that connector disconnected.
So this battery is a 273 milliamp hour that yields a whopping 1.03 watt hour of power. It offers 32% increased power over the previous generation. So that's kind of cool, but it had a lot of adhesive compared to last time?
Yes, the bottom of the adhesive features a adhesive pad making a small L, which holds it in place a lot. It doesn't seem really necessary, but I understand that they don't want that rocking around in there. So next thing I want to take out is this taptic engine, but before I can do that, there's a screw hidden away in this corner, so I'm going to remove these connectors for the microphone and the touch gasket. Just that simple. This cable here that is connected to the back of the S2 motherboard so that I can get my taptic engine out. Just like so.
So here's Apple's tiny taptic engine for the Apple Watch. It's super cute compared to what I just took apart in the iPhone. It's Apple's linear resonant actuator. It creates a motion of a straight line as opposed to a circular motion of an electric motor, which provides that haptic feedback that you feel when you press the screen. Okay, so attached to this taptic engine, we have the little unassuming speaker right here, which does a really cool thing, and I'm super excited about it. It expels water, right?
Yeah, I'm totally geeking out about this speaker. It's definitely an interesting take on how to waterproof something. I mean, they have gaskets and O-rings everywhere, but this little speaker doesn't care about being in the water. It lets the water in and then uses the vibration of the speaker to just push the water out and keep on trucking.
That's so cool. Love it.
So next we're gonna start having to tackle the octopus of cables, but before we do, we're going to take out the force touch gasket and the antenna so that we have a little bit clearer view of what's going on. Now that I've started it, I can just take my tweezers and gently pry it up without tearing it, of course. Working my way around this second set of adhesive. We should have this out in no time. Now that we have the force touch sensor gasket off, we're going to be working on this antenna. Three small screws, but shouldn't be too much of a problem. Now that we have the screws out, we can take out this little connector holding them in. And there it is.
So this is the antenna, and it's got the cool new GPS, right?
Yeah, the old one only did Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, but this one incorporates a GPS location in the one and only antenna. So here I have the microphone bracket that I'm going to remove, and this shows another example of how they tried to make sure this watch was going to be waterproof with the O-ring here designed to protect it from all the water ingress, making sure that this would be water resistant up to 50 meters. Next, I'm going to take out the two screws that hold in the side button, the internal side button bracket. And this exposes the side button, which decides to just fall out, showing the same O-ring that they had in the Series 1. So I've gone and removed the rest of the screws around the edge, nothing new or innovative compared to the last Apple Watch. But before I can get to the S2, I'm gonna try to get this mess of cables a little bit out of the way. There's a little connector down here that's trying to give me a hard time. Now that we have all the bits and bobs out of the way and got all those cables away, I'm gonna take a note from our teardown team, have a cut 6-pick to get underneath this S2 so that we can get it out without damaging it, and hopefully, perfect, we get the beautiful new S2 with the connectors on the correct side. So last but not least, we have the charging coils and LED for the heart rate monitor. I've taken the black sticker that they had on top of this off so we can get a better look at it before I take it out. And it's just magnetic, so I can just take it and peel it right off the back, like that. And that shows us straight through to the back of this fine piece of technology.
And we're done. That was fun. These are tiny, tiny pieces. It's an amazing piece of tiny technology. Mm-hmm. But what did you how do you feel about the S2 as compared to the first version?
So it's really very similar. It ends up being a lot of the same technology. Everything is more or less in the same place. There is only 17 screws in this one compared to the 18 in the Series 1. It's surprising, but there's a lot of complexity in here. Again, we see, like, as soon as you go beyond battery or display, it's really going to be next to impossible to repair anything. It's not that bad to open once you know the tricks, but I think that it's going to be heavily unrepairable for a lot of issues that you might run into.
That's a bummer. But thank you so much for coming on and showing us how to do it like a pro. If you're interested in seeing the entire full teardown, go ahead and check it out at iFixit.com.